What if nobody buys your online course? Honestly, there can be multiple reasons, and since I have failed different times in the last 12 years, I want to share with you my perspective about this topic and what to do if this unpleasant situation happens. My name is Max Cecco, and I teach you the skills and mindset to turn your knowledge or someone else's expertise into a seven-figure business. If you like my content, subscribe to this channel and hit the like button. Reason number one. Weakness of communication. The question is, what does weakness of communication stand for? I have just opened the doors to a wide and interesting topic. Especially if you start from scratch and no one knows you, every time you want to create and offer a new online course, you should create a product launch. It means a series of communication to involve your target audience even in the creation process of your successful info product. Most professionals I worked with in the last 12 years, before understanding the launch process, tried to sell their information and knowledge only once they had completed the online course. And sometimes they were afraid of running paid ads and or creating their online presence on social networks. In a nutshell, no one knew them, and therefore selling their online courses was pretty impossible. The key here is this. Selling means educating your target audience and preparing them, persuading them to buy your online course or service before releasing the online course itself. By doing so, you create expectations about your online course and about the results, the transformation your target audience can achieve once they put into practice your package knowledge. If you don't create these perceptions, you will not be able to sell your online course. For sure, if you perfectly execute the product launch strategy, you will get huge sales during the 7-day launch, for instance. But if you want to continue selling your online course, you have to develop a great marketing funnel, a combination of communication and technical stuff, to persuade your potential clients to become paid customers, to make sales ideally every single day. Marketing is all about crafting the right perceptions and expectations in order to persuade your target audience to buy your product or service. Now, let's switch to the second reason nobody buys your stuff. Reason number two, your offer sucks. Creating irresistible offers is one of the best abilities you should master if you want to sell your digital products or services. If your offer is not compelling enough, your ideal client will not buy your online course or service. Now, regardless of whether you want to sell a $97 online course or a $5,000 offer, clients are always looking for a transformation. They are only interested in the outcome they will achieve once they complete your online course. In addition, no one cares about all the details of your fantastic course. I made this mistake multiple times in the past by describing every single detail on my fucking super online course. By doing so, you are eliciting doubts and questions from your potential buyer. And sometimes, the less you say, the better it is. Creating irresistible offers is a wide topic because there are different parameters you should pay attention to, and it all depends on what you want to sell and the price of your online course. With that said, when you create your offer, keep in mind these three variables that influence the offer creation. Variable number one, fast results. No matter what you are selling, people are willing to pay money to get fast results. And ideally, they want to buy your online course and get the results the day after. When you create your offer, think about what to include to speed up the results your clients want to achieve. Variable number two, minimize the effort. The less effort is required to get the outcome your clients want, the better it is, and the more compelling your offer is. This is the main reason why weight loss pills sell like crazy, even if they don't produce any result. But people still buy that shit. Variable number three, increase the likelihood of achievement. Sometimes People don't buy not because they don't believe in you or in what you're selling. They don't buy because they don't believe enough in themselves to put into practice what you teach to get what they want. So you need to persuade your potential clients to believe in themselves first, and no matter the starting point, they have to believe they can achieve the results they want thanks to your help. Now, let's move to the final reason why people could not buy your online course or service. Reason number three, wrong or undefined target audience. You might think this is a weak reason, but it is not. Let me explain why. I have been helping professionals and business owners share their knowledge and experience since 2009. And I can assure you that most of them didn't have any idea of their target audience. Many of them didn't have a strong brand positioning, didn't identify who they wanted to serve because they thought their product was for everyone. This is the exact recipe to fail. If you don't work on your brand positioning first, you will not be able to create the perfect online course or service for your target audience, and you will not be able to create an irresistible offer. That's it. You are not for everyone. But based on who you want to serve, you should use the right communication in order to satisfy that specific client. Many people who approach digital marketing by selling online courses don't follow a step-by-step strategy to reach the desired results. And then these are the same people that complain about everything. Digital marketing doesn't work. Marketers are all liars. And okay, most of them are, so pay attention. And so on. So, do not start crafting the online course without knowing your target audience, your brand positioning, which problems you want to help your clients to fix, and much other essential information that let you succeed in the business world. And never ever forget the basics. You are in business when you can fix people's problems. With that said, the first step to create a strong business is to identify your brand positioning. This is why I urge you to watch this video, 3-step strategy to create an effective brand positioning. This video helps you to be perceived differently from the competition and identify who you want to serve. So, watch it now.